This is a big piece of cottonwood. And it is wet. I don't know if you can see or not, but it has thrown water all the way over to my other lathe. I guess I shouldn't say water, I should say sap. It's going to be quite the bowl. It's plastering my face shield. I'm gonna have to clean my lathe. I can feel the sap flying off of it. Getting there. That's bizarre. Oh. Can't go to 400 yet. they went way out of balance, and I had to...
That sonic is probably the slowest sonic I've ever been to in my life, period.
Yeah?
That's sonic.
Gonna get this off of here. Yeah, I know. I gotta grab the camera and show this. Look at this, is so wet. That's sap sling off. And down here you can see it. All the way back here. This is where most of it's landing, right here. Look at this, pelting my other lathe motor. Good grief. Craziness. It's the wettest wood ever. I'm going to make one more pass and then I'm going to check and see if I go this way. Get in the shower.
Yeah. That's impressive.
Oh, we got a lot more of it gone. This is definitely going to end up a platter. Didn't like that. I'm gonna turn that off anyway. Oh man. Like I can't get past this.
It can be in there. That's pretty though.
What's that?
That's pretty. Where the stress is. It's almost like a marbling effect.
This is close. Ah! On here, it's like a half inch thick, but this should be right at the edge of it.
It's frustrating, isn't it? You think you're almost there.
I think I'm done, but I'm not.
Yeah.
This is getting really cool.
That is, it is. It's almost like a marbling. You know, it's like a marble.
What's that?
A piece of marble.
Oh yeah.
It's got that kind of...
I'm good to here. That's about where I need to start. It's only going to be about a half inch thick out of the edge.
By the time, yeah. Dang.
Look at that. I'm thinking about leaving it like that.
Or you're going to wind up having to cut too much off.
I got to cut a ton of it.
Is that still part of the cambium layer?
What's that?
Is it still part of the cambium layer?
This is, this stuff here is. It's because that bark came so close to the edge on this one side.
Look how gold it is. Like,
I know.
Gold. It's really pretty. I'm enjoying just watching it, like how it keeps changing.
I may have to go work some more of it up. I mean, there's a whole bunch of it laying out there on the ground.
You gotta have to dry up a little bit. What is this piece of wood that I'm standing on?
I should have kept, we didn't have our toilets replaced. I could have brought one to you.
Look at this. It turned dark with all the sap that got into it.
Wow.
That was white before. finger on something. I don't know what it is.
Like a paper cut.
Really? Well, let's see. Oh, Chuck looks on there. Well, it's not perfect, but it's going to do. I wonder what time it is.
It's 10.
10 after 10. Holy cow. Well, let's see if we can take it off. That's a marble.
See, that's what mine was doing the other day too.
It's possible that it went out around that fast. I mean, you know, it might be. It's just drying.
That's what made me stop and not finish off that other one, even though it had a low moisture reading. I was like, eh, something's not right. I'm gonna just let it sit here for, you know, a couple days. I'm interested to see what. If some of that stuff comes through.
I should probably put the tail stack up. Should turn it off so I don't catch it on there.
And that really just helps hold it up there, right?
Yeah, that's just to give it support, so if it tries to break off the tenon, it doesn't immediately fly. It's not turning around. It's gonna be pretty grain on it though.
Let me see. I stepped out of the way, I was getting shot.
So here's the feathering from the crotch.
That's beautiful.
I don't know why this is. That looks so weird.
I'm almost wondering if it's just drumming that fast. Well, it's gotta be. You're slinging it off.
I think because it's a crotch, it's holding the water in different spots, and so that's...
Look at it.
Isn't that pretty?
It's really pretty. Who'd have thought this cursed brab... not brab prepared.
But look, I'm hitting that... Remember you said it got fuzzy on you?
Uh-huh.
That's what I'm hitting now.
Is it more that... It's not cambium though, is it?
I don't think so. That was only the setup.
Weird.
It's just too wet, I think. Boy, look at the grain though, wow.
You'd have thought cotton could look like that, right?
Yeah.
They're not as wet as I thought they were going to be.
Already been flung off. Oh boy.
So is it like tearing out here? Like what is...
Yeah, it's trying to tear out there too. But it cut right through that.
Yeah.
It's the stuff down here that's not one cut. That's better. It's got some tear out, but man, look at that green.
I'm wondering, it's beautiful. You almost got a modern look going where it's thick on the edge.
Yeah, see, we got a problem here. I got to take this edge down a bit. See how it's chainsawed?
Yeah. That grain is beautiful.
Well, I'm thinking I don't want to go much deeper, unless, you know, in case I lose it.
Yeah. How much do you have on this side? Yeah, and you have to let it...
It has to dry anyway, so this side's about the right thickness.
Thank you.
hit it level.
Look how out of round this one went. I'm looking at some of your balls on your table.
Yeah?
This one.
Yeah, I know.
It's like an oval.
Take some of the sharpness out of that. How thick is that down there? I don't know how far in I can get. About 2.5 inches. But this is a 20. How big is this bowl now? Let me get my
see what we ended up with.
Here, I think it's 21. I think it's gonna be 21 as well.
That flat so you can see it on the video.
Oh.
Yeah, it looks like it's right on 21.
Dang.
It is beautiful though.
Yeah.
It's a little too thick in the base. Yeah, but I think once it dries, you won't have this issue.
So I'm wondering if I should get on the, come out in the back here and take some off.
That thing's cool the way it almost looks like a piece of marble, you know, like the way it's.
Yeah, I know.
Because you can see even, look, it's even in the.
I know, it's got some of that character there. This tear-out, it won't do that so much once it gets dry.
Once it dries. But you do it, that's what I was talking about, like it was frustrating me. For
yeah.
I was like, ah!
Oh, this is really rotten.
There. I'm just hoping it doesn't come
out. That's right across from this thing.
I'm hoping it doesn't come out. I kind of like it. I hope it just smooths up a little.
Yeah, I'll bet it doesn't. Look at all this cool.
Look, when you turn the light, look at it. How, when you...
I know. Well, it's actually texture. Feel it?
Yeah.
It's actually texture. But see, once it dries, we'll be able to cut that smooth.
Yeah.
Now with it wet, it's just riding right up over it.
I get excited for this stuff now.
I know. That's going to be beautiful.
It will be beautiful.
It just doesn't crack. Golly, how do I keep it from cracking?
Anchor seal it.
Well, I could anchor seal it, but I hate to.
Because if you have a crack,
it takes so long.
Got a weak spot right there.
I know.
Which is pretty right now.
Goes all the way back here.
So it goes all the way through. So you might want to put.
And this is already a crack.
Yeah, so I'm saying it looks pretty from here, but you might want to put something on it. Oh, so it goes all the way.
It actually goes all the way around. You can follow it all the way on that ring. This is so bizarre how this turned red. That's so weird.
See, I'm going to try to take the...
Looks like a critter.
I should bring the camera over and show it.
This, remnants of the cambium. That was white when I stopped turning it. And as it slung sap into it, it turned brown. Now it looks like a critter laying on the back of the bowl. Just look at all this cool texture. Wow. I just keep it from cracking. Wow.
The back edge is as pretty as the front.
I know.